Starting with numerical number 19, the displacement of an oscillating particle is given by the equation A sine omega t plus B cos omega t, where A, B and omega are constants. A, B, omega are constants. Okay, prove that particle performs linear SHM with amplitude. Okay, they are asking to prove this thing. That is, A is equal to under root A square plus B square. Okay. It is very simple. Here you will directly go to trigonometry. If this is your A, this is your B, so what will be the value of this side? Of course, this is 90. You can go by Pythagoras theorem. That is, A square, B square. That will give you third side. That is C square. Instead of C, you can call it as capital A. Now why I am doing this, I'll explain you afterwards. So here I'll write capital A. So once you take the square on this side, this becomes square root of A square plus B square, that is equal to capital A. And here you have this. So the proof which is given in the question itself told me, or the equation which is given in the question itself told me, that one side and the other side of the right angle triangle will be small a and small b, and the hypotenuse side will be capital A. Okay, so here I have just drawn the triangle with the help of the equation given in the question, and I have checked it afterwards whether my substitution is right or wrong. Substitution of the value of sides and hypotenuse is right or wrong. Okay. So instead of capital A over here, can I write this value? Yes, of course I can write this value instead of capital A, that is under root A square plus B square. I know many of you might have not understood this part. You can just go back and listen to this again. Now you can take this as theta. Sine theta is opposite upon hypotenuse. So which value you have in the opposite? That is B. And hypotenuse pe you have under root A square plus B square. So it is sine theta, which is equal to B under root of A square plus B square. So from here you get the value of small b, that is under root of A square plus B square into sine theta. Okay, now you will move to cos theta, that is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent is small a and hypotenuse under root A square plus B square. So from here you will get the value of small a, that is under root of A square plus B square cos theta. Now why we are finding the value of a and b? Because here you have a and b. You will substitute these two values, that is x is equal to, the value of a is this, under root A square plus B square cos theta, and then you have sine omega t plus value of B is under root A square plus B square sine theta, and then you have cos omega t. If you see A square plus B square, A square plus B square under root, that is common, so remove that out. Here you will have in the bracket cos theta sin omega t plus sin theta cos omega t. If I see this as, I substitute theta as a, or I can also take omega t as a, that would be better, and theta as b. So it is sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. That is equal to sin A plus B. Rest, the term outside bracket remains same. So what is A? A is omega T. And what is B? That is theta. So under root A square plus B square sin omega T plus theta is equal to x. Now if I compare it with the displacement of simple harmonic motion, that is a sine omega t plus phi. So at place of amplitude I have this thing. This tells me that amplitude is equal to under root of a square plus b square.